Cool, man. So yeah, this is definitely, we got it, the hot seats today at a different time. For the last few, we've been doing them at night, and I know some people have a hard time making it at night, especially in Europe. So sometimes I'll have them in the afternoon. So we kind of a lot, we'll get a different crowd in, different people, usually not as many people are on either because a lot of people are working. But it's good to mix it up. Plus, this weekend we're going to Vegas for the assimilation and for Becker's event. So I had to do it early anyway because I have to leave. So it kind of worked out. So let me do this. Let me ask you guys, how many people here, is this the first time you've been on a hot seat? Give me a, well, here's, let me tell you this. I wanna, before you put in the question box, I'm in the OMG Way Facebook group. And, so right here, we're in OMG Way. So what I want you to do is just go right here and then in the OMG Way Facebook group and put in, hashtag first time. So I know. I just curious to know how many people this is their first hot seat they've been on, kind of where we're at. Okay, so we got Linda, Tom, Vinny, Dan. Yeah, so we got quite a few people. Oh, 10th time. This is Dan's 10th time. Wow. So you've been on quite a bit. First time, week three. All right, Garrett. So, all right, guys. All right, James Westura. Well, I want to welcome everybody. And week two, says Daryl. So, just to give you guys a rundown of what it is, a lot of people know it's real simple. I'll do some question and answers. Also, we'll bring some people on live. And instead of just me trying to read the question and figure out what's going on. We'll bring you on live and you'll be able to kind of talk to us, talk to me, tell me what's going on. And it's a lot easier to dissect the problem. It doesn't matter if you're just starting. It doesn't matter if you don't even have a website up or you even, you have nothing going on yet. Because part of, what it is it's not only doing the work, creating the website, ranking it. Sometimes it's just how to get started. Sometimes it's making a plan. Sometimes it's just getting the motivation to get things done. So the hot seats are really for anybody. A lot of times I'll have Gregory Ortiz on, or sometimes Fletch comes on, and I'll usually have guests on. But this week, all you have is me. So just because of the schedule and everything that's going on. But that's okay. All right. So week eight says Stellan. JT says first time. Sean wants to be on a hot seat. All right. So here's what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna answer a few questions. If you guys want to be on a hot seat, what I want you to do is in the question box, just say I want to be on a hot seat, and then tell me why. So don't tell me why in the Facebook group, but you can do it in the question box. I know somebody Facebook messaged me just about 20 minutes ago asking me to be on the hot seat, and if I don't remember her name, so. If it was you, just let me know and I'll definitely bring you on. Then again, after we go through some questions, maybe a hot seat, I'll show you what I was talking about in the description about getting some free links, and it actually fits into the slides that I did 2 weeks ago. Also, last week the recording failed, but somebody actually recorded it, so we have a recording that David Mills is going to post. And last week I had on, Joshua Fletcher and Scott Shaft, and it was following along the themes of lead generation, ranking in multiple cities, and different things like that. So, all right. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to get in here. I'm going to hit a couple of questions. Okay. So Brian says, can we still get the OMG blueprint for assimilation one? Yeah, I'm sure you can, Brian. You have to probably ask. I don't know. It should be in there. I don't know if David's. I actually don't know if David still has the blueprint or not. You may want to email omg@omgmachines.com and find out. Can we create a custom map in a city with different keywords to rank the same business and address? Yeah, I mean, I'm sure you can create a custom map for any city. I don't do a lot with creating custom maps. I know Derek does, and I know that there was an assimilation that they went into custom maps a lot, like last month. I just don't remember which one it was, so you might have to look at those. I think David is putting descriptions under them now. Okay, so here's another question. In my agency site, GWT, in my agency site, the GWT, under construction data, I'm getting Hantam markup error dated 26th of March. Man, I don't know the answer to this one. You on the schema markup, that might be a good question, Tejas, for Fletch for the schema. All right. So Darcy Hall says live. See you in Vegas soon. All right, Darcy, we will see you there tomorrow. I'll be getting there at 3 p.m. tomorrow. So, let's see. David East. All right. So he says he needs a hot seat. Okay. I emailed you, but no response. I'll try again. Brian, what did you email me about? I don't know. Just let me know in the question box if you want to come on a hot seat. Oh, the blueprint. Yeah. Just try emailing again. Okay, so Quentin says, on a lead gen site for multiple locations, how important is it to have multiple pages for each city to build on-site relevance? I think it's pretty important. And again, that's kind of what we went over the last 2 weeks, that if you're doing a multi-location site, whether it be lead gen or a client site or anything, the more location pages you have. Now, the way I do it, like I said, is I have big cities. Like I'll have San Diego, I'll have LA, I'll have Chicago, and I'll create those pages. Now, I don't usually create the suburbs in those cities. I'll just create the bigger cities. And then when you send links and everything, like I showed you a couple of weeks ago, to those pages, it builds the authority of the site, and then everything just starts ranking a lot easier. For tiered keyword search on crowdsearch.me, do we need to have Google Analytics installed on our money site? If not, how does Google know our bounce rate, time spent on a competitor's website for a tiered search campaign? Listen, having Google Analytics on your money site is, to me, very important. Because like a lot of people say, oh, don't put Google Analytics because Google's going to find out what you're doing. They're going to find out anyway. They have data on your site. The Google Analytics, if you think about it, if it's your money site that you're trying to rank, especially if you're in local, what does a normal business do, a normal website that's trying to rank, that's legitimate, have? They have Google Analytics. The only thing you might not want to put analytics on is your PBNs and stuff. But like your money site, you definitely want to do analytics. It's going to give you very, very important data. So yes, if you're doing a tiered linking campaign, if you're looking at bounce rate, all that, you do need analytics on your money site for sure. You mentioned Manta on an Assimilation Lite webinar. I recently set this up and suggest everyone else do the same, since Manta seeks out and syncs to other profiles and citations. Good stuff, the wrapper. Yes, Todd. Exactly. If you guys don't know what he's talking about the link wrapping, Cotton and myself did a OMG Light webinar a few weeks ago where we talked about that. So you might want to check that out. But Manta is definitely one of my staple citations that I use all the time. Hey, Joe, quick question about PBN links. I remember you and Cotton mentioned you recommend using one PBN link for one money site. However, and Cotton mentioned in the PBN webinars that you can send one link to the money site and one to the social profile. So that's two. I mean, listen, guys, you can mix it up for sure. If you look at the over the shoulder, whoops. If you look at the over the shoulder that Greg and myself did, the Iowa City SEO, you'll see when he linked from his PBNs, on some of those PBNs, he linked to three sites. He might be linked to a Facebook page, a Twitter page, and a YouTube, right? Or he linked to the money site and a Facebook page. I mean, you can definitely do that. You wouldn't want to do it like, say, if you have five PBNs and every PBN you link to your money site and your Facebook, money site and Facebook, because then you're leaving a footprint. No, you want to mix it up. Maybe one PBN, your Facebook, and your money site, or another one, maybe your Twitter and your Facebook. You know, mix it up so you don't leave a footprint. But I mean, you could definitely do that. I think what it is, you know, if you have PBN, say, right, and you have three different money sites, and you have 10 PBNs, and, you know, five of those PBNs are linking to all three money sites, then that's a trackable footprint. Because what's the odds of, you know, two websites linking to the same site? Okay, it's pretty low, just randomly. Now, what about five? Then, you know, so then it starts leaving a footprint and it starts looking very unnatural. All right, so Elizabeth says she just got her first international client. Well, that's awesome, Elizabeth. So Elizabeth, man, she's been coming on some hot seats. She's been with us for a couple of months now. So that is awesome. So let's do this, guys. What I want you guys to do is I want you guys to give a congrats. Let's give a congrats to Elizabeth. It's Elizabeth. Let's see. I don't know how to pronounce her last name. But here, Elizabeth Engen. But man, she's been working really, really hard. She's been on almost every webinar. I think I've seen her on every hot seat, every assimilation light. She's been asking a lot of questions and taking massive, massive action. And guys, if you want to succeed, if you want to make money at this, you got to take massive action. You got to ask questions. You got to get on the webinar, ask questions, come on the hot seat. I mean, even if it's uncomfortable, that's how you move ahead. So I know she's been working real hard, and we got, you know, over 100 people on the webinar. So man, the more congrats we can give her, the better, you know. So okay. So Angela asks, someone made a review video of my product. Should I upload it on my YouTube channel, or should it come from a channel of the person that reviewed the product? Okay, so I've gotten this question before, and I've seen this question in the Facebook group. Is okay, so Angela's asking about a review for a product. Some people some people will get reviews for their business or for their client. So, you know, say you have a client and someone gives them a review, or they come to the office and your client records the review. Well, should you put that in their YouTube? On their YouTube channel, or should they have the client put it on theirs, or should they make up some random YouTube channel and put the review video on there so it looks more natural? I think it's 100% fine to put the review on your client's YouTube channel, or in this case, if it's a product that someone sent you a review for, putting it on your YouTube channel, because, you know, someone made a video and sent it to you, so you posted it. I don't think there's anything fishy with that at all. So then, you know, you're just uploading reviews that people gave you, and they're all in one spot where people could watch them. So I think there's no problem of you putting a review video on your website. Okay, here it is. Okay, so as Patsy had a question, and she's thinking that she got a penalty because she did a Wirecast video. So I want to bring her on because that's definitely not the case. It's impossible, and I'll explain in a minute, to get a penalty by uploading a YouTube video. All right, let's see. So it's Patsy Wilson. All right, Patsy, I am going to unmute you, and we're going to have our first hot seat tonight. Hold on, you have to. So listen, guys, I want you to do is I want to get a hashtag hot seat in here. I know we're trying. I'm being a little more active today because it is the afternoon, but let's do it. Let's do it. We'll get ready. I'm going to do about 2-3 hot seats, maybe a little more. So give me a hashtag hot seat right here while I try to find Patsy's name. And just send this. Okay. I got it right here. Patsy Wilson. Patsy, looks like your mic is muted. So, okay, there you are. Hello? I see your mic is unmuted, but I can't hear you. Okay. So, Patsy, I don't know if your mic's not working or not, but do me a favor. If you get your mic situated or fixed, I mean, I see it here that it's green, but then just hit me up in the question box and I'll bring you on. Okay. Oh, wait. Looks like she's logging in again. So maybe if she comes on again, we'll come back to her. Okay. So we're going to come back to Pat. Oh, wait. Let me see this. All right.
Okay, I think I'm unmuted.
All right, I think we got you, Patsy. Okay.
All right.
The
deal is, I know it's not just doing the Wirecast video. It's just that I had other SEO companies take my tagline from that and like hijack it. And so now there's about 5 SEO companies that have used the best SEO in Charlotte. And then they'll click on to that with their domain.
Yeah.
And so when you put CP Wilson Group .com in the search bar for Google, it comes up. It's an index. When you take it out, it shows up on the second page, and all that spammy stuff shows up on the first page.
Well, so here's the thing: is you can't get penalized by someone using the same words as you. The only way you get penalized is if you're over-optimized for a keyword from your anchor text, meaning links that are linking to your website, or if you're getting links to your site from bad neighborhoods. A YouTube video, now I know this isn't your question, but I want to clear this up, that a YouTube video, even if you have your link in the description, and people send links to that YouTube video for some reason or embed that video, it's not going to affect your site because those are what's called nofollow links. So basically Google they're not counted. So but your question is, so now I put your site in here and it seems to be coming up. Okay, so you don't have a penalty because to check for penalties you put in your site without the period. You know, and I don't see any penalty happening right here.
Okay, but if you're looking on the first page like I am, that CP Wilson Group, yes, that's mine. But then underneath it, it says halfdomains.co, whatever. That stuff's not me. All those next three aren't me.
This isn't you right here? This is you, right?
No. CP Wilson Group. Okay, now so what you did, yes. You clicked on CS.
No, I see what you're saying. Okay, so you're saying so CP Wilson. Gotcha. Okay, so CS Wilson is not you. You're CP Wilson.
Right. on C.P. Wilson. But when you do the C.P. Wilson without the period, the first thing that pops up is like halfdomains.co. But they're using my domain in it. You know what I mean?
Well, yeah. Now let me ask you this: what? How long have you noticed this for?
Let's see. I think I posted it about a month ago that I've been hijacked, and I didn't know if it was going to affect my rankings or whatever. But I'm not ranking. And
right. No. Is this? It's C.P. Wilson. Let me do this. Okay, let me do that. Yeah, no, there's definitely something going on with your site. So it may be some links. I mean, have you been – you're going to have to check the links. And how long have you had this site for?
What, 2 months?
Okay, so it's a new site. How many links have you been sending to it?
I've probably got about 80 socials.
That's it? You haven't sent any PBN links or anything to it?
I just sent my PBN up yesterday.
Huh. I mean, because it's so you only have social links. That's not enough to get it.
Okay. You just pulled up the CS. Click on the WP.
No, it's CP up here. It's CP Wilson. This just says a suggestion. Yeah.
No, it says showing results for because I went through the same BS.
Okay. That's why I wasn't showing for. Okay. Well, you're still not showing up, so.
That's what I'm saying. And see, that down there where I want to be number one on Google, that's what they hijacked.
Yeah, I mean, that's not going to do it. That's not going to do it, saying someone taking your tagline and just saying it isn't. Is it, what's going to do it is your, is if you're over optimized or if you're, or links or you got some kind of penalty or something. Do you have Google Analytics on here?
Yes, I do on that side.
Google Webmaster Tools?
Yeah.
Is there any penalty in Google Webmaster?
I haven't run it lately, to be honest.
I mean, I don't know. It could be that there could be a few reasons for it. I mean, if this is a brand new domain, it's not aged, you only have social links going to it, odds are you're really not penalized. I just put in like your title right here, and you came up. It could be that your site just needs a little more authority. So, because I mean, when I put in your name, you're ranking number one. So if you were penalized, you wouldn't be ranking right here. Okay. So that one penalty check is just one of the things you'd look at. And then you look at a few other things. So I'm looking at it right now. I put in CP Wilson Group SEO. If you were penalized, you would not be showing up here. Okay. But you are. So it may be that you just need to send a few more PBN links, you know, to get it going a little more here. Let's see. So because what's happening is like the Facebook group is popping up because Facebook is higher domain authority and it has more authority than your site does right now. But you're right here. So for the term CP Wilson group. So I don't think you're penalized at all. Yeah.
All right. No spammy stuff. Because, I mean, you took out the period, then all that other stuff where they took my, like, half domains, and then they added on my domain, and then the other one they added on, they had their domain. And some of those companies, I looked at their pages, and it's like, down at the bottom, they'll have other recommendations. And it's like a half a page long of all this stuff.
Are they sending links to your site? Are they sending links to your site?
No.
I don't see any links going to your site. I just put this in, and I see no links going to your site right now. Okay, so that means, I mean, Ahrefs is pretty much going to show whatever links, and I don't show any. So what it is the problem is you don't have any links going to your site, you know?
Okay, so but you saw all my socials, so you're not saying that. You're just talking about a PBN,
Yeah,
PBNs.
PBNs or anything that's being picked up right now. I mean, you have Facebook and everything else, but you know, sometimes they don't even count, you know, but you don't have any other links that are showing up. So let's see.
If you keep going down the pages, I mean, like my About Me comes up. I mean, a GitHub, all this
Right.
stuff
So it's just not
where I work.
it just may be too new right now. So it's not hasn't been crawled yet through the Ahrefs, but like you don't have any spammy links. So it's so like for your site to get penalized, you would need like these sites would have to be sending likes. I mean, sending links to your site. So if their sites were linking to your site, then they would show up here, and then you'd say, "Oh man, I'm over-optimized for anchor text. They're sending me these bad links," but you don't nothing's showing up here. So I think what it is you just need to send some PBN links to your site, let it age a little bit, and let it start moving along, you know?
Okay.
I don't see anything to tell me that you're penalized. So I think you're fine. I mean, I
Overreacting.
would put more content on your homepage for sure, you know? So like looking at your homepage, what do you want to rank for? Charlotte SEO?
Best
Charlotte.
SEO in
Okay, so all right.
Charlotte SEO.
All right, so if you want best
S
SEO in Charlotte, North Carolina, that should be the first thing in your title tag. CP Wilson Group should be after best SEO in Charlotte. So in your title tag, make sure you have your keyword right first thing in your, you know, and I would put some more content on this page. I would definitely put some more content on this page, and I'd have the word, you know, now I wouldn't overdo it, but I would definitely have the word, and I would have the word and maybe a couple of related keywords like search. If you're looking for search engine optimization in Charlotte, you know, call CP Wilson. Here's our number. Okay. Well, now we put, and I would put that in probably an H1 or a title tag, or if you're looking for SEO in Charlotte or something like that, you know, it's very important to get your keyword in H1 or H2 tag, but that puts it in there, but it also puts the phone number, puts a call to action. It looks natural. Then I'd have, you know, I like to have at least 500, 600 words on the homepage, and then in there sprinkle in some keywords, not stuff it. And that's going to do a lot for you.
I don't think that page is getting indexed. I went over this with Mark Ro, whatever is Rowinski, and the only pages that are showing up in my WordPress are YSEO, About Us, Discovery Page, Recommendations, and Contact Us. That does your
Your homepage is indexed. Your
all
homepage is
right.
indexed. Right here, it's definitely indexed. I mean,
Okay.
it's showing up. Like when I put in CP Wilson Group, your homepage shows up. So it's indexed. It's indexed. So your other pages, you know, it's just going to take some time. I mean, I'm sure you have a site map on here, and if Mark's doing your site, then you definitely have everything.
Well, he didn't do it. I just
Okay, so
hired him for some information.
all right. So I mean, what you want to do is you could always go on Google Webmasters if you see one of your pages that are not indexed and do where it'll call it to come and crawl your site, but your homepage is indexed. I think what the thing is you need to put change your title tag, you need to put some more content in here, you need to put an H1 tag in here. I mean, make the content look like it belongs there, but don't, you know, don't stuff it. But you definitely want to put some words on here. It's gonna help you out a lot. All right.
Okay. And then my other question was about the mobile. I don't know if you know about that, but I put the Jetpack on two different WordPress sites, And it didn't do anything but slow them down when I went did
Well,
the speed
what's
analyzer.
this theme? This theme might be mobile compatible, and so it might already have a mobile function on it. So.
Well, yeah, my fight's okay, but the speed is slow. But what they were talking about the other day was that you could get clients and tell them you'll make a mobile compatible by using Jetpack, and
No,
I did that, and
yeah,
it
it's do
slowed
not
it down.
right. So I don't know. I mean, you have to get a web guide if you're gonna use Jetpack and stuff, but do.mobile. So you go to do. This is for making sites mobile fast. What it is you subscribe to them and they host it. They actually make a mobile site that mimics the desktop site, but they put it on an M dot. So it's actually hosted somewhere else. So they make a complete mobile site, and it's as easy as just uploading the site, drag and drop, boom, they have a mobile site. So if you're going to do mobile sites for clients, I suggest you get do.mobile is what I suggest you use because it's easy to use, it's fast to use. There's a website that Stephen Floyd and Cotton did where they really broke this down. I think it was last spring or something. I don't remember the exact weapon where they broke it down how to use this. I think Steven's the one's been using this a long time, and I've used it and it works very well. So this is what I would suggest doing
All right.
for mobile.
Okay. Cool. Thank you.
All right, Patsy. Well, thanks for coming on. Hopefully that helped you out.
Yep. Thank you so much.
Okay. All right. So that was good. Let me hit a couple of. All right, guys. So that was good. Let's get back and let's do another hot seat. Let's get on it and guys. Hot seat. I have Arizona. Let's see. All right, let me. Let's see. Okay. All right, guys. So I'm just going through here. I got a couple of hot seats on. Okay, I got Sean here, and he's got a question. So Sean Drayton, let's bring him on. Man, this when I get too many people on this GoToWebinar, it's really a pain to go through here. Hold on, so it just takes me a second. I think I need another mouse, is what I need. Got the wrong mouse for my computer. Here he is. Okay. Man, this is. All right, so I don't know what's going on with this. I can't even move and unmute people. This thing's freezing up on me. I may have to run and get my other mouse because this mouse is not working. Yeah, I can't even move around and get unmute people because I'm having problems screening through this GoToMeeting. It's been screwing up lately. All right, so. Oh, here we go. All right, I got it now. Because I can use my. Just bear with me. Some technical problems, but I think I got it worked out. Because I can use my down button. I don't need to use the mouse. Sean QRS. Here he is. Sean Drayton. Let's unmute him. Hey,
Hey,
Sean.
awesome.
How's it going?
Hey, can you hear me?
Yeah, I got it. I got it. Finally, it worked.
Good stuff. Good stuff.
Good.
Been a patient wait, but well worth it.
Okay, so how can we help you?
All right. That last hot seat that you just had actually kind of answered a good couple of questions that I had, so we can skip through those.
Okay.
So the first question was, the other day when you were online with Cotton, you guys talked about a wire cost alternative software that you've you beta testing.
Uh-huh.
I was just wondering if I can keep my hand up there as one of the 50 that you're going to beta test if you're still offering that.
Yeah, we are. I'll get it to a bunch of people, everyone, the first 50, and if you guys message me too, I'll get it to you. The thing is, we've been working on it for a while, and there's still a couple of bugs, and I'm not going to release it until I get the bugs worked out. But once the bugs are worked out of it, definitely I'll give you guys, everyone at OMG is going to be able to get it. It's going to be credit based, and that's all. Every time someone uploads a video, it's on a cloud, so it costs money to run, but it's going to be I'm giving everybody a bunch of free credits right off the bat, and it's going to be really cheap. So it's not.
Oh, that's awesome. No, man, you're a good man. Thank you for that. Yeah. Eh?
Yeah. I mean, yeah, for OMG, it's going to be like almost running at cost. So, but anyway, yeah, when that's ready, I'll believe me, I'll have as many people who want to get on, I'll be able to get on it. So.
Well, nice one. Thanks, man.
All right.
Okay, the second one I had was, while I was just watching the video you're going through, or the hot seat that you're going through 2 minutes ago,
yeah.
I noticed you're using Ahrefs and Moz OpenSite Explorer. Now, you know, with OMG Command Center, mm-hmm. isn't all the tools and functionality that you get from those sites included within OMG Command Center?
It is. It is. The difference is if I pull up Ahrefs, I can get it immediately. Something will OpenSite Explorer. If I use OMG Command Center, I put it in, and then it has to like search it out, and then I got to wait for a report. So when I'm doing webinars, it's easy just to go right into Ahrefs. Plus, for me, gotcha. Like Ahrefs has a lot of other features that Command Center doesn't, but if you guys are just starting out, Command Center is perfect, because for you to buy all the subscriptions that you need, that, you know, would be like probably $300-$500 that you can get with one Command Center. And it might not have the speed and everything else, but you don't need all that right now. So, yeah. So
yeah, that's true. It's very expensive with all of these different tools. Things.
Yeah. And they have a lot of other things. Command Center does a lot of stuff. So.
No, that's awesome. I'll be signing up this week with it. All right. When you were talking about the taglines and the site titles earlier,
yeah.
my website, I didn't have the keywords for the location that I'm in. So I'm in Perth, in Australia, and I don't have the keywords in the site title. I had them in the tagline. So I had a long tagline that said website design, mobile application design, and internet marketing and search engine optimization in Perth. I don't know if that's too long. But should I be shortening the tagline as one thing? And for the site title, should I be just saying search engine optimization in Perth as my main keyword?
Well, so you're saying, so your tagline, are you talking about the meta description? So
so the meta description, yeah.
Right. So the meta description, you have a certain amount of words that you can do before they cut it off. You know, so you want to kind of keep it in there, which it looks like, you know, you're doing it's okay. But if you want to, you know, your title is what the way I work it is, the title is my main keyword. The number one keyword I want to go after, that's the title. So I may do, well, look, let's look at here. Let's look at one of the example sites we have. Let's look at. So if we look at Iowa City SEO, you see what the first line is Iowa City SEO. Okay. Then we have the second keyword we want to rank for, which is Iowa SEO, and then web design company. These are related keywords and secondary keywords, but our main focus is Iowa City SEO. So we have that right there in the title. Then you can see our description. You know, it's a sentence, a little more than a sentence. You know, welcome to Iowa City SEO. There's our keyword. SEO agency is a related keyword. SEO company is a related keyword. So we have some related keywords in there also.
Can I pause you there for 1 second, Joe?
Yeah.
So I get that with all my, I mean, I've set that up with all my pages, every single individual page. It was more just with the home page. So on the home page, if you're in WordPress and you go through to the appearances section.
Right.
And then you're going into just customizing your main site title and tagline. That's what seems to be coming up. So maybe I should actually just give you my website.
Well, let me show you something. I'll show you. So let me log in. This is an example I used last week, but I could just log in here and show you WordPress. Let's log in.
Yeah, that'll work.
This is just a dumpy demo site. Anyway, it doesn't matter. So let me. So there's a couple of different ways you can do your title tag and title description. Okay, if you have no SEO plugins, then you would go to
appearance and then down. Yeah.
No, you'd go to settings and then you'd go to general. Okay, so here's your site title. So this is going to be, if you don't have an SEO plugin, this is going to be your title tag. This is going to be your meta description right here. Okay? If you don't have any other plugins. So in general, site title, tagline. Now, what I would suggest you do is put in a plugin. One of the plugins you could use, I don't have it in here, is All-in-One SEO.
Yeah, I've already got it in.
Okay, so when you put your title tag in there and the description in there, then that's it.
Okay. That was what was throwing me, is the fact that I do use All-in-One SEO Pro, and I've done all my titles, meta tags, descriptions, keywords, everything, because you know you get the three different columns and you just populate every column. Mm-hmm. So I've done all of that. But then there was this one area, this one feature under the appearances section where it was asking for a site title and a tagline. And that was just like at conflicts with what the homepage settings were with All-in-One SEO.
So you're talking about here under Customize?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I don't do it through there. I just do it through All-in-One SEO, and then you know, and I make sure that the general, I make sure that matches the All-in-One SEO, and then that's it. I don't really do anything else. So I don't know where.
No,
I don't even know where this All-in-One SEO pack went to, because it usually shows up on the left-hand side. Oh, here it is. Yeah. So what I'll do, and then. Two is you don't want to use All-in-One SEO and something like Yoast at the same time. What you want to do is you want to use one or the other. And I like this one because, like Yoast and some of these other ones, they create sitemaps and all this other stuff, and I don't want it creating my sitemaps. I put the title here, description here. These are going to be your tags right here. That's it. You know, that's what I'll do. I won't worry about it, anything else. And then, you know, so that's where you want to put it.
Okay. No, that's brilliant. That helped because it was just the fact that there was two different areas for configuring the same settings, and I wasn't sure which one I should be doing.
Right. And then also when you do a page or a post, you're going to notice when you have All-in-One SEO pack, right, you can – here's the title. So you could change it. So if you don't have this and you don't change it, what's going to happen is your title tag is going to be the title of your page. And then usually it's the first couple of sentences. Now, you know, what'll happen too sometimes with the meta description is if your page is ranking for a keyword that's not in here in your meta description, but it's somewhere on your page, it'll display that in the search results as your meta description.
There was one that while you're on that one, because I do that with all my posts. I've got about 102 posts now, And I've been updating all the all-in-one SEO settings across all of the posts. And the one thing I found was so tricky to get the 60 characters or 66 characters in. Does Google look at only 66 characters, or does it look at a bit more than that? You know,
you mean on the title?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you want to keep it under 60. So a lot of times, like, say you do if you do it too long, you shouldn't do more than 60, because here's what you're looking at. You're looking at shooting what up? A high power sniper rifle, right? So you want to get, this is the keyword I want. Okay. If you start stuffing it with 10 different keywords, then it's like, what is this site about? You know, what are we going to rank it for? It's too much information. Like, you want to keep it brief. Now if you had 70 characters, will Google look at the last character? Yeah. It'll just put 60. It'll only display 60. The same way with your description, it's only going to display 160, but it reads everything else. It doesn't stop reading it. I don't know. So I just try to keep it under 60. I try to keep it under 160 characters is what I try to do.
So that's brilliant. So as the title goes there on the ad in your page where you are now, if you went over 60, that's okay. But as long as you try and get your SEO configurable title settings down there at the bottom under 60, then that's all right. So you kind of just have to
I want to put my I want to put my keyword in first and then whatever after, and try to keep under 60. If you go a little over, it's just when you look in the search results, it's going to show three dots. It's not going to show your full it's not going to show your full title. Same thing with your description. If you go too long, it's going to stop and show three dots, and that's all it's going to show.
And the page title, that's all right. That doesn't matter character-wise. Still try to keep it short, but it doesn't
matter. Well, the page title for conversion, you can put whatever you want here. You know, page title, you could put it as long as you want. It just has to make sense as a convert. So for that reason, you don't want to put too much in there. Like, I wouldn't – like, say this was a San Diego page for precision mold removal. Like, so yeah. I would put San Diego mold removal, you know, and mold inspection. That would be my title. Mold removal is what I want to rank for. Mold removal and mold remediation are really the same words in Google's eyes. But then mold inspection is a secondary keyword that, if I can rank for, great. If I don't, fine, because I have a mold inspection page. But it gives context to mold removal. It's related. Then in the description, I might say, you know, here at Precision Mold Removal, we've been doing mold remediation for the San Diego area for the past 30 years. If you need a mold inspection and you live in the greater San Diego area, give us a call. Okay. So yeah, I wouldn't continue to go on. You know, mold removal Carlsbad, mold removal Encinitas, you know, those are all suburbs of San Diego. Like, I wouldn't stuff it with water damage, with flood damage, remove, because they're not related enough. I'm not going to rank for that, and it's going to affect me ranking for mold removal, because it's going to be too much stuff. It's not specific enough.
Gotcha. All right, no, that's brilliant. Shame I don't want to consume up too much of your time. There's other folk who want to have questions answered too. So that's brilliant. You've been very helpful. Thanks, man, Joe. Appreciate it.
All right, you got it, Sean. Thanks for coming on. I appreciate that. All right.
Thanks, Jess.
Okay, see you later. All right, so let's see. We are so we're going about – here's what I'm going to do. I know I got some more hot seats on here. I know I got some more questions. It's 3 o'clock, and I don't want to go too long. I'm going to show you guys what I'm talking about how to get free links. So some of you guys might know this already. I'm not pulling any crazy tricks out of my hat, but it's something that's very important. I'm going to show you how I use this tool and exactly how I do it, especially if I'm doing lead gen sites. Lead gen sites and everything else. So here's what I want. When I'm getting ready, okay, oh, look at this. Leslie already did it. I want a hashtag free links. okay? So while I'm getting this thing ready, I'm doing it on the other page here. I'm actually going to pull up my thing from last week. And I want a bunch of free links in there. So just give me a second as I go through here. Let's see. Just give me a minute. Okay. I have to find that. This thing's thinking. Yeah. All right, guys. We should have like over 100 free links. Man, we're getting them. All right. I like it. Here we go. What I'm doing is I'm pulling up this, I'm pulling up the PowerPoint that I did a couple of weeks ago. And this thing sure is slow, man. All right, let's see which, that's not it. That's not it either. Hold on, bear with me. Let's try number 13. Okay, here we go. All right, guys. So here's, so we got a bunch of free links, which is awesome. Thanks. It's good, man. I like the interaction on the Facebook group because it makes me, you know, then everyone can see who's on and everything else. So it's nice. And then, all right. So here's this presentation. Let's see. Let me go through these slides. All right, guys. So if you were here 2 weeks ago, you remember I did this this whole thing about, you know, how to set up your lead gen site. If you weren't there, it's from the replay from 2 weeks ago. You can go and check it out. But you'll see here are some links. We got San Diego YouTube channel. Then I have local citations. And the big question is what citations do we use? Like, so if I'm in mold removal, you know, what sites do I use? Well, you know, there's the mega ones like Yelp was brought up, was Manta. You know, I like Merchant Circle. So there's definitely the high authority ones that most businesses have. But if I want to overtake, you know, the person who's ranking high on the maps or in that snack pack, you know, I want to get some of the same local citation that he's using. And especially if you're doing a lead gen site, right? If you're doing a lead gen site, you want to get local citations. But if you're doing a lead gen site, you don't know what local citations, because you're not a real local business. So you have to find out what these local businesses are using. Okay. So here's what I got is I use what's called Bright Local. How many people here have ever heard of Bright Local? Just give me a one in the question box or the Facebook page. Give me a one if you know what Bright Local is. And give me a two if you've never seen this site before. All right. So we got twos, got a lot of ones, got a lot of twos. All right. Okay. So we got a mixed bag, and I'm going to show you guys how I use it, the way I use it, and I know if you watch the Over the Shoulder series, I show Bright Local on there, I think I do. I know I have it somewhere in the back end where Cotton shows White Spark, and I show Bright Local for getting citations. Unfortunately, it does not work in Europe. Oh, I don't know about Europe. Well, there is a manual string, Dan, that you could put in to check citations. I don't know what that string is off the bat. I'll have to find it. Okay. For you guys where it doesn't work, I'll show you a trick on getting citations without it. So just bear with me. And if I go through this whole thing and I forget, then remind me. All right. So Bright Local, here's what I like about Bright Local. It has a lot of different things that it does. It's a rank tracker, and I really like the rank tracker because what this rank tracker does is it actually shows you everything that's ranking on the first page. So, for example, this is a bright local ranking report. And, man, I love it for my clients because if I have them on more than one spot on page one, Bright Local will show them. They shows them the keyword and says, okay, look, you're 1, 2, 3, 5. And it shows them every place that they're ranking, right? So I send them a report and they're seeing all these spots. I'm like, oh, that's all the spots you're ranking. So it looks a lot more impressive than just a ranking report where it just shows them that here's where your site ranks. It's showing them their Yelp page, their video, your Facebook, all, you know, whatever secondary item I have ranking. So that's one thing that I like about it. The other thing is they have an awesome free trial. This free trial, you could pick any one of these plans and you get it free for 30 days. So say I pick this $65 plan. I get 100 searches on the ranking report. I get all this stuff. The only thing I need to sign up for this free trial is an email. That's it. You don't even have to put your credit card in here. They don't make you verify. You just have to put an email in here. And I mean, look, if you wanted to, you could make one account a month, I'm sure, you know, but I would say, listen, if you like it, then just buy it. But you can do all this stuff, you know, for free if you want to. So let's get back to it. So this is what the inside of it looks like. You know, this is the rank tracker right here. And I got my test. I mean, these are the ones I did. The as you check up. So let's get over to. They have two things. They have a citation tracker, and a Google Plus local wizard. And as you can tell, this is a free account that I made with Gregor Ortiz. And so he has some stuff in here, but, I did this report right here earlier. So I'll show you. So let me do this. Let me create a new report. I'll show you how you create a report in here. It's really easy. You, give your report a name. You select how often. I always put ad hoc. If I put monthly, cause what happens is, Bright Local only gives you a certain amount of monthly reports they allow you to run. So if you hit monthly, then it's going to run that report every month at the same time. But if you go over the allotted monthly reports, so let's say there's 10, then you can't run any more reports. But I could run almost as many ad hoc reports as I want. I think like 100. So I always do ad hoc. Then I can add a new location, right? What is going on here? My computer is freaking out. All right, so I don't know if hold on a second. Something's going funky here. Oh man, I know what it is. Hold on a second. I think someone's got my Bluetooth mouse. I think my son grabbed my Bluetooth mouse. Okay. So anyway, so you can add a new location. When you add a new location, this is gonna be whatever the business is. So like for this example, Perry Plumbing, I put their name, their category, and I put their NAP, which is their name, address, phone number. So whatever that is in the Google My Business, that goes here. And then you just put all the details in here. Then you put the search terms that you want. So if it's like plumbing, San Diego plumbing, whatever, you put them all in here and you run a report. Now, once you run the report, we can go here and we can view the report, and let me show you what it looks like. Okay, so when we pull the report up here, it's going to come up. It's going to show us the reviews, but it's also going to show us, so for the keyword term San Diego plumbing, it gives us the stats. So Perry Plumbing is not in the first 50 results. Okay, so they're not really ranking anywhere. But it gives us who is ranking. Okay, and it also tells us how many citations they have, the citation authority, the links that they have, their website authority, their reviews, their pictures, and everything else. Okay. So you could see here we have all different sites. Now, Perry's Plumbing has 71 citations. They have 46. They have 30 links. So they have a lot of stuff, but they're still not ranking because even though they have a lot of things, they don't have the right citations, right? Because they're ranking with 36 over 46. So they probably have better citations. Their website's probably better optimized. Maybe they have more reviews, but really their reviews, if they got 40 reviews, that's a pretty good amount of reviews. They have more pictures here. So we want to know what these guys have over our site, Perry Plumbing. Because if we go through here, we see Black Mountain Plumbing, man, they are dominating every single keyword. So when we go down, it shows us, okay, us, what we have, and then it shows us what our competitor has. So if we go down here, we see this is us, and this is Black Mountain Plumbing. So what we want to do is we see that they have a Google plus Google. We do too. They have Pinterest. We don't. They have a Picasa web.google. So they have a Picasa site. Now Picasa is for photos. So I bet you anything they have their photos in Picasa, and then they probably have them optimized in there. Okay. And then you can actually geotag your photos in Picasa, and I think there's another site, and then upload them. So that's probably what they've done. So this is pretty big, okay? And they're the only one that has that. Facebook, okay, they don't have Facebook. We do. LinkedIn, we don't have LinkedIn. Okay, we both have YouTube. We both have Yahoo, but we don't have a MapQuest. Maybe we should get MapQuest. BBC, yes. Dailymotion, okay. Here's another MapQuest, Yelp. So you could see here as you go on here, it's going to show you some of the things that you want, some of the citations that you want. Merchant Circle, right? Super Pages. And so what I usually do is I'll go through here and I'll check to see, okay, what is the majority of people? What do they have? And if I'm starting brand new, then I'm going to say, okay, every city we're going to do this. Every city we're going to have this, and I'll make a list of probably 40 or 50 of these citation sites that everyone else is using. But if we go through here, you're going to see, and this is why I like Bright Local, is you could find these hidden gems, like San Diego Reader, okay, San Diego Magazine, La Jolla. Like this is a city in San Diego. So you will see that there will be some city-specific citations. And these are super, super powerful because these are local links. These are local recommendations. Like some of these other ones, they're big. Manta, Yelp, all these stuff, you know, people have them. But when you get to the local, even if they're not as powerful, and authority-wise, domain authority, what gives them the power is that they're localized. So I like Bright Local because I can go through here and I can find these local sites, okay? You know, like places to go in San Diego. I want to get on that, you know? And so these things are really, really going to help out. And the other thing you may find is you may find some plumbing citations in here and some niche-specific citations. So as we go down, you know, we see a lot of local stuff. So that's where you guys can get a lot of links from, and it is free, but it's very, very important. So what I do is I have my list of must-haves, and I give that to my outsourcer. And I say, okay, every city page that we create, you need to do these must-haves. And she does them. And then she gets in the Bright Local, puts in the information. And then she goes and I say, and then she finds local and whatever she can, like probably another 5 to 10 local and everything else. So now when we look at this, let me go here. Okay, when we look at this, this is not just a couple of sites. Okay, this is pretty powerful because this is This is like 50 links or 60 links that are local, like directories, but they're also local links, all going to our site. And then, so if San Diego has 40, 50, LA has 40 or 50, you know, Las Vegas has 40 or 50, you could see how all this power just keeps building and building and building. Now, again, I know I said there's a couple of things that, can you rank without citations? Yes, you can rank without citations when your site gets powerful enough. For example, we just put up a page, you know, in Chicago, and we got in the A spot in Chicago right away. Well, it's because our site has built up so much. But will I still do the local directories and citations? Yes. Does that happen if your site does not have authority? No, it won't. But when you look at this stuff, when you look at SEO, when you look at ranking, when you look at systems and procedures and everything you have to do, you have to look at like you're voting, or I don't know, maybe voting, maybe that's a wrong illustration, but that everything has adds to it. So it's like you have 50 things you can do, right? If you do 10 of them, you'll probably succeed. Now, it doesn't matter which 10, as long as you do 10 of them. And so you just, so things add up. So it's like you check one. Okay. I did this. I did this. I did that. And, it just adds to. Now, if you didn't do these local citations, will this still rank? Yes. But you would have to do other things. You'd probably have to do more PBNs, maybe more press releases. Maybe they'll take longer to rank, so this will get you there faster. If you did 10 citations instead of 50, will you still get there? Yes, because you can do other stuff besides this. So what you do is you take all these things, and you know, you just do as many of them as you can. If you can't do one of them, don't get stuck. Just do something else. I know if that makes sense, let me know. Give me a one in the question box. If it doesn't, give me a two. Corey asks, and then if you guys have any questions on this, ask it in the question box. Okay, so if you guys have any question at all, any questions of what I just talked about, put it in the question box. So Corey says, in a search under related images often shows up. Is it possible to SEO those images so yours show up first? Yes, of course, it is possible. It is possible to show up. And I'll show you how to do that. So what he's talking about is if we do this. So if we do, I don't know if this is still ranking. Okay, so here we have a term, prefab stairs. Okay, so when you come up with prefab stairs, this is a client of mine, Discount Quality Stairs. He's number one. Okay, and then I think we're here. We're all over the place, right? But he's number one. But you're gonna see here related images. Okay, but if we look at these images, you look at this, and I click on this image right here. It is, this image is to, goes to his website. Okay. So it brings up his website. So it's a long way around to get to it. But anyway, so what he's asking is for a keyword, can you get the images in here? And if it has images, okay, you can. Like, usually when I mouse over this, it'll show the, all right, see, we got discount quality stairs. This one, I think is it two? So we got like three, you know, and so how do you do that? How do you get the images to pop up over here? It's very, very simple. What you do is you go in and you tag the image. I'll show you guys. Here, I'll show you real quick. Let's go back here. How exactly to do it. So let's go in here. All right, good. So let's go in here. Let's edit this page because there's some images on it. All right, so say I want I want San Diego mold removal. I want this image to come up. So the first thing that has to happen is this page has to be optimized for San Diego mold removal. I have to be trying to rank this page for that keyword. In my experience, now, some I might have different experience. Like I said, in SEO, there's different roads to get to the same spot. In my experience, my site has to be on page one or page two for my images to show up. If I don't do that, my images usually don't show up. Like I said, someone might have a different way they do it, but the page you're working on has to be optimized for that keyword, okay? And it has to be ranking on page one or two. The next thing you have to do is you have to optimize this. Now, how do you optimize this image? Well, right here, you see. See how you got San Diego mold removal in the, this is called an alt tag or alternative text, okay? That's, I want the keyword in the alt tag. It's very important it goes in the alt tag, not the caption, not the title. I want in the alt tag, okay? So that's how you're going to optimize that image in the alt tag. When you go to the page, you know, if I go back to this page and I go over it, it should come up. Usually when you do an alt tag, under any normal circumstances, it'll say San Diego mold removal. But for some reason, it's not working on this webinar. Anyway, you put your alt tag in here. So now you got your on page and stuff. And a lot of times that's really all you need to do. And then it starts ranking. The other thing you can do is when we click on this image, you're going to see that I have an image URL. Okay. And so what you'll do is you could actually backlink this image URL if you want, lightly backlink it. And, you know, if that'll help move it into that section. Now there's other stuff you can do. But I find that this, just doing this will get you in that area. So hopefully that answers your question. But that's how easy it is to rank, an image. If you're already on page one, you got the image tagged, it's gonna more than likely show up in there. What is GMB? That's Google My Business. So this is Google My Business. Can you send backlinks to Citation? Yes, of course you can. That's one of the things too we show inside of that over the shoulder series with Iowa City SEO. Is that you can backlink your citations. Actually, well, you know, you could send backlinks to the citations, and that's how you get multiple spots on page one. Also, like you could backlink your Yelp page, your Manter page, Facebook page, and what that'll do is that'll give more power to those pages, which will then in turn give more power to your page, your ranking, your money site. But it'll also move those sites up to page one. And so now you're taking up more real estate on page one. What is your starting point for number of citations and or social profiles? So my starting point is when I'm doing multiple cities, I always want Facebook. I want Twitter. I want Manta. I want Merchant Circle. You know, I want the big ones, okay? I want the big ones that most people are going to have, the bigger social sites. You know, those are a must. I go through here. If I'm, I take the niche and I go through here and I find the ones that have the most authority I have or the ones that most is using. I may even take an average of three cities, okay? Because if you're doing lead gen and starting this business, building a site that's going to make you $30,000 to $50,000 a month, okay, $300,000 to $500,000 a year, it's going to take some groundwork. It's going to take some foundation building. This is foundation building. So what I'll do is, I may take three or four cities. I may put up all four of these pages up on the screen, and you know, on a couple of screens that I have, and I'll look at all the common what are the common ones that they all have, okay, those. And then I pick the ones with most authority. You know, they all have this. They all have Yelp, MapQuest. Those are going to be my primaries. Then I have a spreadsheet and I put all those primaries on there. And so then every time we start a new city, every city gets these citations. And then we go on And then we try to find local ones and other ones like that. If you do not have an address for lead gen, can you still get these citations? You can. You just have to make up an address. Now, we talked about this on the Simulation Lite, and I always do this every time I talk about faking an address. It's do it at your own risk, okay? Know the risk. If you fake an address, okay, and you use it for citations, you probably the citation companies are never pick it up. But if you use it for your Google My Business and they pick it up and find out what you're doing, they will shut you down, okay? So know the risk. That being said, yes, you can. If I go, you can go into a city, you can go on, look for a building for rent and find a suite that's for lease, or, you know, or make up a suite number with that address and use that as your business. Okay. I wouldn't use a storefront because storefronts are always people moving in and out of storefronts, and, you know, like a shopping center. And a lot of those will use Google My Business, whereas, or others, or Yelp or something. Whereas some office complex that rents out an office is probably not going to. So, what do you use to do your press releases? I use PR Reach, and I really like this as a press release because they do an awesome job at the press releases and distribution, but they also create a killer video that I upload to the YouTube channel. And I talk about this in that video section that I have. So let me pause this. I hate that it auto starts, but this is PR Reach. And you can see, like, so you get a press release and they make these videos that they give you. So like when I get a new client, we automatically do a PR Reach. I get this video and I immediately start ranking it. And then like when we enter a city, you know, I immediately do a PR Reach press release, gets my information out there in that city that I have arrived. And then we start ranking the PR Reach video. We have a unique video for that city right off the bat. So it kills two birds at one stone with one stone. Okay. So Sean says, hey, Joe, quick one. If your alt tag and description on images is the same, is that a bad idea? No, but it's not necessary. You don't want to stuff these images. You don't want to stuff the images so that it's, you know, where you just have the hammering the keyword over and over and over again. So what I would do is if I was going to put something else in the description, I would put a related keyword. So if it's SEO San Diego, I would put search engine optimization San Diego. You know, if it's mold removal San Diego, I would put mold remediation service in San Diego area or something like that. You know, I would try to mix it up a little bit. And the other thing is, let me see if I can find an image without... Let me see if I can find an image, and I want to show you guys something else. Hold on. I got to go through these folders, which I don't know what's in the folder. So if I open them up on the screen, we could be... So the other thing you can do with images is you can actually tag inside the image. Okay? So let's see here. Let me pull this image over. Okay. I like this image. This image, it's pretty funny. I hate being bipolar. It's awesome. Anyway, this is just a JPEG. Okay. So when you have a JPEG, you can go down here. Now I've done it. I do it on Windows. I don't really do it on a Mac, but on Windows, I know you can go down and you can actually go and go to the properties, and you could change the properties inside the image. And I know you can probably do it with Mac too. I just haven't done it before. So I mean, look, you can add tags to the image if you want. Anyway, I don't know. I know you can do it with Mac, but right off the bat, I'm not sure how we would I don't know. I don't know how to do it right now. So if anybody knows how to get to there with Mac, let me know, because I'm not sure how to do it with Mac. But anyway, if you're on a Windows computer and you right click a JPEG, you're going to be able to go to the properties, and then you're going to be able to enter a title, description, and tag. So if you want to, you can actually do deep tags into a photo. But again, if you did that, I would not stuff the image. Okay. I wouldn't put the keyword over and over again. I would do it. So I would put related keywords and everything else in there. Okay. So Corey says you can do it under get info. Okay. All right. So, okay. So that's that. Let me get to the next question. Would you explain how to backlink that URL to the image? Basically, that image I showed you guys was a URL, right? So this every image that's loaded, you know, is actually there's a URL for it. It's hosted on your site. Like this one is this is the URL, okay? So you see, this is actually the image. Okay? This is actually the image. So you see this dot JPEG, but this is actually the URL. So if I go here and I just stick this in the search engine, it's going to pop up. Okay. So if I sent some links to this, like say I sent a PBN link to it, or, you know, a couple of web 2.0, I mean, you don't have to do a lot of links to it, but you can send a couple of links to this, and then it starts giving this a little more authority or is related. Now, you don't have to do it a lot of times. If you just get your site up to page one or two, your image is going to show up without having to do that. So hopefully I answered your question. There was two questions. So if that didn't answer, let me know. Three questions. Okay. So I don't know. A lot of people are at, hopefully that covered backlinking the image. Do you mean link from the lead gen site to Manta or Yelp when you say backlink them? No, what I'm saying is you got the link from Yelp going to the lead gen site. The link from Facebook going to the lead gen site. You could send links to the Facebook. So it'll go links to Facebook, you know, it would feed down like that. So to rank more in the snack pack for more keywords, I have to get more citations with keywords. I want to rank. What is the efficiency of images geolocalized in these citation sites? Yeah, you know, you can – she's asking about geotagging these images, which you can do that. You can do that under the properties like I showed you. And there's also other ways through Picasa you can do it. I think there's another way to do it where you can put in your longitude and latitude and localize. I don't know. I mean, it's just one more vote. It's just one more point in your favor. Like, let's say point system. I guess that's better explained. It's just one point. If you don't do it, are you not going to rank? No. If you do it, is it going to make a massive difference? No. But is it going to give you more of a chance of ranking? Yes. If you have, is it just another point that adds up that helps you get to where you want to go? Yes. So it's not a magic trick. It's not like if you put these localization stuff on there, it's going to automatically rank. It's just part of the bigger picture. You can do that. I'm not going to show you guys how to do that right now. I'm not set up to. I know Steven has shown it in the past and he's probably going to show it again, but. It's pretty simple to do. If you go to Picasa, or there's another site, I forget the name of it now. It's so easy. It just says what's the longitude and latitude. The other way you could geotag it is simply put it in the most effective way is this. Okay. Is change the name. Just name this what you want. You know, I can name this San Diego mold removal. Okay. So what I do, I used to do all that, right? I would go into the image and I would edit the JPEG. I'd edit the properties. I would throw them in and I would put the geotag markup on there. I do all this stuff. But now all we do is we get a bunch of unique images and we just have certain keywords that we use and we put them in. Now, so say if I'm going to put in 10 images on my Yelp page, all 10 images are not going to say San Diego mold removal. One will say San Diego mold removal. One will say San Diego mold remediation truck, right? And I'll have a picture of a truck. Now, well, I do that because I want the keyword in there, but it's also a truck. So it would make sense that I would label that picture truck. Or I might put, you know, mold remediation or mold testing or something else like mold damage, picture of mold damage in San Diego home. So, you know, so I'd have related keywords all in here on there. So that a lot of times for me, that's enough. But like I said, if you want to go the extra mile, you can. It's not going to hurt you. And yeah, it can add it. Is the juice worth the squeeze? I don't know, you know, but okay. Can we use Fiverr gigs to backlink citations or PBNs better? I just want to save PBNs for money sites. Yes. I mean, you could use Web 2.0s to link, but you want to make sure that if you're going to send links to these citations, and if you're going to use something like Fiverr, which is very sketchy, you want to make sure that the citations offer no follow links. Give me a one in the question box if you guys don't know what no follow links are. Give me a one if you have no idea what I'm talking about when I say no follow. Now, some of you brand new people aren't going to know. Okay. Most people know. What I'll do is I'll show you real quick what it is. Okay. Now, let me wait for this thing to come up. There's two. Okay. I'm going to go briefly over this. And we have more information on no follow, do follow links, but in the members area, obviously in the training. Do follow link, okay? So let's do this. Let's look at this. Let's look at this right now. A do follow link, okay, is a PBN. Like say PBN links means that I tag a do follow, meaning that I want to send the authority of my site over to my website. So that means if this is a do follow link, that means this link counts, that I'm giving a vote. A link is basically a vote of a vote of a recommendation. It says I'm recommending San Diego mold removal, that it's a good site, go here. And I want to send my link juice. If you think of the authority of a site as juice, they call it link juice, right? So say I got so much juice. I got 100 gallons of juice right here of power. And I want to send some of this juice, or I want to send some of this power over to this site. So I'm going to say, okay, a do follow will allow some of my juice to flow over to this site. Okay, so it gives him some power. It's a transfer of power. No follow means like Facebook is no follow. It says, okay, I'm linking to this site, but I'm not giving it juice or power, and I'm not 100% recommending it. It's no follow. So basically, it's a neutral link. It won't harm me. So if this is in a bad neighborhood and it's no follow, it's not going to harm me. If it's do follow, you know, and it's in a bad neighborhood, yeah, it can harm me. Now, that being said, will do no follow still work? And if I backlink this Facebook page, will some of that authority transfer over even though it's no follow? You know, I think it does. You know, people may argue with me, but if you look, I think it does. But some of it does. Not as much as it do follow, okay? But it still will, even though it's a no follow. Now, how do you tell? Okay, so here's a site right here. This is a toolbar that I have. It's Moz. Just go to Moz toolbar, right? Just look up Moz toolbar for Firefox. Or I think Chrome has it too. And you can see it's a little highlight section here. It's going to say highlight pink for no follow, and green for do follow. So we're going to do no follow, and I'm going to go to Yelp. Okay. So now Yelp is no follow. Okay. So I'm going to do mold removal. Let's just find a site in Brookhaven, New York, right? Let me pull up one of these. I'll pull this guy up. So now what it's going to do, it's going to highlight the link. Dun, dun, dun. Which now it's not doing. Well, is it follow? Oh, huh. I guess it's, I thought this was no follow. I guess it's do follow. All right. So this is highlighting green, which is weird. I almost positive this was no follow, but so this is a do follow link. Okay. So what that means is it's passing some of its juice over to the site. Okay. So this is do follow. If we go to like Facebook, right? So let me do this. Let me go to a Facebook page. Is no follow. Mold removal. Let's see if someone even has a Facebook page up here for mold removal. Okay, here we go. Fast mold removal. So if we go here, you're going to see here's a link, okay, but it's not highlighted. I mean, well, dude, I could have sworn this was a no-follow link to Facebook, but I don't know if it's going wrong or if this tool is just off. Anyway, if it's no-follow, it'll show up pink. If it's do-follow, it'll show up green. So, you know, that's how you tell no-follow to do-follow. BBB's no follow. All right, yeah. So I don't know. I could have sworn these were all no follow. But all right, let me know if you guys are now thoroughly confused between no follow and do follow. Give me one if you're still confused. Okay, let's look at BBB. All right, so this is a no-follow link. Okay, so now if I took this BBB page, Better Business Bureau, and I sent a bunch of links to it that were spammy, that is not going to transfer over to my site. Okay, I'm not in danger of my site getting penalized. But if I did it to the Yelp page, then, you know, that is possible. That's a possible way for me to get my site to get penalized because it can pass through that do follow link. No follow in post section. Yeah, I know, but I could have sworn I checked in Facebook and it was no follow before. I don't know if it's changed or what, or maybe I'm dreaming. I don't know. But anyway, so Facebook is following. I think it was no follow. And they might have changed it, but I know it was no follow at one time. But anyway, I wouldn't GSA this. Like someone asked, can you GSA or can you spam it? I wouldn't spam anything. I would, you know, I would try to send better quality links to it. A lot of times, like if you look in the Iowa City SEO, we linked to some of these things from our PBNs. And what happened was they actually moved up faster. You know, so the site actually moved up. They moves up pretty fast because you're sending a powerful link to it. It's already on a powerful domain. You should see that. You see the domain authority is 95. It doesn't take much to raise a page authority. So since you're on such a powerful domain already, and if you have your keyword and URL, you send a couple of PBN links, it's going to move fast, way faster than your own website. So a lot of times I'll go into a certain city, and the first thing I try to rank is a video. Then I rank the Yelp page, Facebook, and then a lot of times my website will come up along after. So what is the point to post on nofollow links? Just to get traffic, right? Yeah, but you also do receive credit for those nofollow links. I know it's counterintuitive. It doesn't make sense, but it's not black and white. It's not this is this and that's that. But like, so if you're doing a lot of, usually a lot of times citations will be no, maybe no follow. But I would still do citations because they're going to help you with your Google My Business and everything else. Like BBB's no follow, but Google does see it and it does give you, okay, this guy's a real business. It does help out your site overall. Okay. Blown up. So it does help out your site, you know, overall. So I would still have them, and it's natural to have a mix of do follow and no follow links. Yeah, it's again, yes, it's a trust signal. Put it in a link wrap. Yes. Yes. Okay. All right. So that's about it. And all right, guys, if you have any questions on that, let me know. Can we use a PBN to link to a citation and the corresponding money site? You can do that, yes, but I wouldn't do that over and over and over again. So can you link from a PBN to your money site, right? And then link from that same PBN to your Facebook page? Yes, you can. Now, would I do that with three PBNs in a row? No, I wouldn't, because that would create a Facebook page. I mean, no, that would create a footprint, not a Facebook page. That would create a footprint. So you want to be careful. You want to think. So you have to think about your combinations when you do them. And again, in that Over the Shoulder series, Greg talks about this in detail and shows how he sets up those links. When sending PBN links to BBB or Yelp listing, what type of anchor text do you recommend? I mean, I would just vary it up. You know, I might put BBB page. I might put Yelp page. I might put San Diego Mold Yelp page or something else like that. I would just mix up. Again, look at that Over the Shoulder series. Great covers, anchor, all that stuff. Okay, yeah, the substitute. All right. All right, so here's a good question from Brian. If there was a problem with spam hitting follow links, is that where you would use the detox site to clean it up? Yeah, so, I mean, if somebody was, say, spamming, like, can I drop a site? So if this is a do follow link, can I spam, mainly with anchor text, this Yelp page and drop this site? You know, technically, yes, you can do that. Okay. What would you have to do is you would just disavow this Yelp, URL is all you can really do if somebody was doing that. Yes. Does no follow links show up in OpenSite Explorer? Yes, they do, and they're in brackets that say no follow. Okay, so let me get back to these other. All right, so the URL string. Let me pull up. I don't know it off the top of my head, so let me do this. I don't know what the URL string is off the top of my head, but I do know it's in here somewhere. I did a module. It's been a while where I show how to do that. And it's in kind of the archives because it is an older way of looking at it. Sorry, guys. Okay, right here. So you guys see this here in your members area? Google My Business listing. Okay, so this is kind of, so now you're going to see it's mixed up between Cotton and myself. This is Cotton's. He goes over White Spark. Okay, I go over different ways. So I have an overview and a follow-up. Let me see what this overview is. So in here, I don't know. The search string I show in here. So you got to watch this video. Sorry. And it goes through and it tells you the search string. It's either in there or here. Oh, here it is, search string. Okay. So just watch this video and see, I have some stuff on Bright Local. I go more. But just watch this video and you'll see the search string, and then you'll be able to see how to find powerful citations that your competition's using, okay, without Bright Local. It's not as effective. It's not as good as Bright Local. But if you don't have something like Bright Local, this is another alternative that is free to do. So just go to Google My Business Listings, go to follow up, okay? And then it's in there, okay? So, I mean, some of this stuff, the other stuff might be outdated, like the Google My Business. I think that was back, I was showing Google Plus, but this stuff is not. This is still current. All right, so that's the one if you're out of the country. Let's see. Okay, guys, I got to hit a couple more questions, and then I got to roll out. Okay, let me just see. Can I create a lead gen site for the keyword hydration pack using Google My Business so it will show up in Google Maps when someone simply types in hydration pack in the city like New York, Seattle, Phoenix? Would it work like that even though they don't geotag the searches? Yes. What I mean, yes, what I mean is if I go to Google, right, and I type in plumbing, just I type in plumbing, right? So here what's going to pop up is Roto-Rooter, Martin's Plumbing. So now this is showing me results for my area in New York. The reason why these guys show up is because their pages are optimized for my location. If they weren't optimized for my location, they wouldn't show up. So like, so Roto-Rooter has a Long Island page or a New York page, and that's what's showing up. Now, you can't just have it and not have that city page, not be ranking in that city, right? So if I do, you know, plumbing where I live, Medford, New York, you know, Roto-Rooter is going to show up, okay, because they're optimized for it. So you have to already be optimized for your location for it to show up when someone types it in without the geo target. Okay. All right, let me hit a couple more questions. Citation Crusher videos are removed. Oh, they are? Huh. Okay. Well, I didn't know that. I have a client who has a YouTube channel, but does not have the email password for it. Any idea how I can find out what it is? I need a channel because his company video is on it with a lot of views, but the description does not have his company info. Yeah, I mean, the only thing you can do is try and log in, and it's very, if you have no information on that YouTube channel, like if he doesn't even know the Gmail account or anything, it's hard. So you just, they're going to ask you like what date was the channel set up with, and they're going to ask you a bunch of questions you may not know. So I have a couple of channels like that I can never crack. So I don't know. If worst comes to worst, you just download the video and just upload it again if you can't find it. Can these tactics be applied to a Shopify store? I don't know. I'm sure it can. I don't know much about Shopify. Let's say, Joe, this is answering so many questions I have missed along. Good. I'm glad this is helping you out, Leslie. Let's see. We just set up our first PBN and we're already sent two links with anchor to in two different days, but the anchor text doesn't show. Yeah, well, okay. So he's saying he sent anchors from his PBN to his money site, but they're not showing in Ahrefs or Moz. If you set up your PBNs correctly, then they shouldn't show up, because you don't want them to show up in Ahrefs. You don't want them to show up in Moz. Because what happens is your competition can take your site, put it in Ahrefs, and see all your links, and they can find your PBNs. So there's plugins that will hide them, like Spider Spanker will hide it, so that, and you put that on your PBN, and then these aggregates, Ahrefs and Moz, it doesn't allow them to crawl your PBN, so they can't find the link. But if you don't have that and it's not showing up, it's probably because they haven't crawled your site yet. It's not instant. So what has to happen is Moz, which has been terrible lately, you know, they crawl sites like every couple months, it seems. Ahrefs is a little better. But you put your site up the same way Google crawls your site. Well, Moz has to send a bot out. That bot has to find your site. Then that bot has to crawl your site, and it has to crawl your PBNs, and it has to find all these links. So it doesn't happen right away. For local, is it better to have less high-quality citations that many would some not as powerful? Is there a minimum as far as strength goes? So he's asking is, what's the strength of these citations that we're sending? The thing is I want, obviously, the higher the authority of citation, the better, right? I don't want some weirdo citation that's obviously looks like spam. It's not even worth the effort, let alone is it going to hurt, right? You have the tools that you could find the most authoritative citations, so use those. Now, when it comes to local, like, okay, if I'm in San Diego and I find a local directory that looks legit, do I want to put my information in, even though it's less authority? Yes, because it's local. Okay, so local makes up for it. So hopefully that makes sense. Patsy says you could use HideMyWP. Oh, what's the matter with the competition finding your PBNs? A lot. Like, so if they find your PBN network, you know, they're going to find out, okay, they're going to know that you're doing PBN. So they could, one, they could report you to Google if they want to. Two, they could see what other sites you have on your PBNs. They could try to hack your PBNs. I mean, there's all kinds of things they can do. So it's just good to hide them. All right. Cool deal, guys. All right, guys, I got to roll. My voice is killing me. And I got to get ready. I got to go on another webinar, and then I got to leave here. So let me do this. I'll bring on Jim wants to come on. So let me bring him on real quick. Jim, we only got less than 10 minutes, but he says he got a client. So let's see what he's got going on here. Hey, Jim, you're not muted. Yeah. How's it going, Jim?
Pretty good. I've got a client. He's an AC guy. He did work for me.
Okay.
And he hates his current SEO guy. He says he's paying a bunch of money a month and nothing's happening.
Okay.
We're in the Houston area. Houston's surrounded by a bunch of little towns. And that's really where he wants to be active, not in the city necessarily of Houston. Okay. And Dallas is built sort of the same way. It's kind of really three centers. So I looked at his website, and the only mention of anything besides Alvin, which isn't even big enough to consider, mm-hmm. is on a page, on an inner page with other small cities. Again, Houston's not mentioned. And I'm just looking for a strategy to I guess, geocenter his business and his clients when I fix him up.
Right. All right. So is he ranking anywhere right now?
Barely. He's not even ranking in Alvin, and it's only 25,000 people. I mean, he's there, but he should be first, and he's like sixth.
All right. So you could do a couple of things. So in Houston, how many of these smaller cities is there?
Man, I don't know. Some of them are so small that they link together and share a police department.
Okay.
So say 20.
20. All right. So you could do a couple of things. One, what you want to do is you want to get them fixed up, right? You want to get him probably ranking for Houston, even though he doesn't want to rank for Houston. I don't know why he wouldn't, right?
Because, well, no, I'm not saying he doesn't, but if I just went to Houston, then where he actually is, you know, I don't know what page he'd show up on.
Well, how far outside of Houston is he? Is he in Houston proper? Is his address Houston? Or
no, he's south of Houston, but say, like, I live in Pearland. There's 100,000 people in Pearland. That's a pretty good sized town. The towns on either side of us are about 40 to 60,000, but those are all the places where he's working. And he doesn't really show up for them. But Houston's okay, but he doesn't need to drive up into town. He probably has 300,000 to 500,000 people he can work with.
Whatever, he doesn't want to go up, like, say, so he doesn't want to go to every even city, right? He doesn't want to go to North Houston. He wants to stay south.
Right. I mean, that's kind of the idea. Just everything south of Houston.
All right. So he wants to stay in a certain geological area. So
how many
suburbs would you say that is, or cities would you say that is?
Just say there's 20 of them.
So now that's not all of Houston. That's just the southern area that he wants to hit.
Correct.
Okay. You can do a couple of things. Like, I like to, like, I compare it to a lot of stuff I did in San Diego is very similar, where you have San Diego proper, and then you have North County, South County, and all these suburbs. So what I would usually do is I would hit San Diego, okay? And I would make my San Diego, the site, the main site would be based in San Diego. That would be that there would be an address in San Diego. So that would be the homepage. But then I would have separate pages for each of the sub cities. And then I would find that these sub cities would rank pretty fast because there was no competition in them.
Right.
So I would create, like, say, I would have a lot of clients that they really like to stay in North County, San Diego, which would encompass about 15 cities. So I would create 15 pages, and then those would be, and I would use them as locations and put those pages up and then rank those pages. And then, so I would rank in San Diego and I would rank for all these sub cities because I had these pages. Now, that's more work because you have to create these pages, and these pages should be unique. They shouldn't be all the same content. The other thing you can do is you can create the site, have a location page and have those locations on that page. You can have the main site, put the locations on the homepage and say, listen, we also service these areas, you know, and try and see what it ranks for. But if you really want to get into those smaller cities, creating a page for them, you know, would help you rank it probably faster because you would have the keyword in the URL and that page would be just for those cities. What's the competition like in these smaller cities? Is there bigger, is there competition there?
I'm new enough to this so that I'm not confident that I've actually nailed all that down. I'm still working through some of that, but we used to be called the most air conditioned city in the world. So there's competition every direction you go.
So is there like a snack pack and stuff on like a Google Maps 3-pack on every page?
There can be easily. Yeah.
I mean, but is there like, so if there is, and if there isn't, it makes it difference. But so what's generally going to happen is what you can do is when you do is Google My Business, it's going to ask you for a radius. And if you're servicing a radius, you want to put the radius in there, make sure that these cities cover that radius. Now, to show up in each of these cities in that Google Maps area, it could be tricky. Like, it usually, to know if I'm going to get in each one of those cities, I have to be doing it, and then I kind of see what happens. By creating a page for it, by optimizing your site for it, if your site is coming up on that page, a lot of times your Google My Business will come up.
Okay. I mean, I did that for my SEO. I live in Pearland.
Yeah.
And I wanted to see stuff happen, so I didn't start with Houston.
Right.
And it, you know, I was there fairly quickly. Yeah. So I guess I was thinking that might work. And if his address is where it is now, can cover all those things within a radius, I was thinking that might be a good strategy. But
yeah.
I don't mind screwing mine up. I don't want to screw his up.
No, well, the thing is if what, I mean, what's his address?
He's in Alvin.
All right, Alvin. So he's not even in Houston, right?
Yeah, he's a little bit farther away than I am, about
Right.
10 more miles.
So, I mean, if you use his current address in Alvin, you put
The
put where
radius.
he services, odds are he's going to rank in Alvin right away. And
Yeah.
getting him in Houston is going to be harder because he doesn't have a Houston address. So
Right.
his Alvin address, for that keyword, he's not going to rank in Houston, probably in the maps, unless he has a I'm just saying, unless he has a Houston address, because it's very
Yeah.
competitive. They're only showing three, and I could guarantee you all three of them have a Houston address. So you
Sure.
have to make choices. If he doesn't want Houston anyway, because it's too broad, it's too much work, and he wants to work on the local areas, then you can do it in Alvin and start working the local areas. Now, man, I don't know what assimilation webinar this was. It's a couple of months back. You're going to have to go and look. Derek went through and he showed a tactic for ranking in multiple cities using Google Maps Creator, whatever he does. It's different than what I do, but whatever he does, he was showing you how to do that to rank in multiple cities. You know, like I do, what I do is I make the page have massive authority for the main city, and it usually busts it into all the different suburbs. This isn't a tactic you probably, this client wants, because one, he doesn't want to be in Houston. Two, he probably doesn't want to wait for all that to happen. So your technique's going to be a little different, and I would
Yeah.
find that assimilation, because Derek broke it down very, very nicely.
Okay. And the regular simulation, the ones on Wednesdays, not the
Right.
simulation light.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Assimilation light for new people. So no, it's the ones on Wednesday. It's where
Right.
Cotton, on those, Cotton goes into really next level, deeper stuff.
Yeah. I don't think he would mind working in Houston, but he lives south and all his business that he currently has is in that area. So driving all over
You know,
those areas plus Houston is,
yeah,
more.
no,
But he wouldn't mind growing.
right. But I know what he's saying, because I had clients like that where I lived in North County, San Diego.
Yeah.
And they didn't
So
want for them to drive down to San Diego for an estimate. You know, it didn't, they would rather drive to Vista or
yeah.
Encinitas, because that's
Yeah,
where
it's
they
like
are.
that.
So we end up, you know, like what I did with them is I set them up where I charged them a month. I think it was like $2,500 a month. And I said, what we're going to do is we're going to work on one subsidy at a time. So, okay, you're located in Vista. So we're going to work on Vista. I'm going to create a video. I'm going to create press release. I'm going to create a page. I'm going to do all the stuff for Vista. I says, then what we're going to do is the next month we're going to work on this. And next month we're going to work on this city and this city. So I didn't say, listen, we're going to rank all at once. I said, we're going to take one city at a time. So what this did was it got them paying me monthly. And they weren't just paying me and they didn't know what was going on. And I wasn't saying we're going to pop up everywhere right away. So we're going to hit this. And then it was very easy for me to come up in a subsidy. So when I started showing up for that, I said, okay, now we're going to move over to the next one. Now we're going to move over to the next one. And what it did is it got them paying me every month, and they were happy to pay me because they're seeing results. I mean, so
Yeah.
Okay. That's just what I did. Doesn't mean you got to do that, but.
Great. I really appreciate your
All
time.
right. All right, Jim.
Good.
I got to get rolling. It's a little bit
Thanks a lot.
over 2 hours. All right, Jim. Thanks.
Bye.
Bye. All right. So, local is better. Okay, guys. So, let me see a couple more things here. All right, guys. So I got to get going. Listen, guys, do me a favor. If you guys, okay, guys, if you guys like the hot seats or something, just let me know in the Facebook group. Just give me something about the hot seats that you like. It doesn't have to be big. It just helps us. Like, we did that with Assimilation Lite, and it kind of helps with the promos a little bit. So, if you guys find some value in the hot seats, just give me a post inside the Facebook group. I'd appreciate it. And then also, if you guys want to get on a hot seat and you want to make sure you get on a hot seat, and if I missed you, I'm sorry, just ran out of time, give me a message. Just message me on Facebook. Okay, message me on Facebook, and then I'll make sure that I get you on. A lot of times if you message me a day before or that Thursday, it's helps me out better than like if you missed me right now, because I get a lot of messages. But I'm going to try to set something up where you guys put your questions in ahead of time. But just do that. And yeah. And that's it. And guys, thank you all for coming. And we will talk to you next week.